Hello, so if you want in Affinity Designer to cut out a shape out of a photo, you need to use the masking tools and the subtract or the combination tools, but they won't work all at the way you expect them to work because then the photo is a photo and it needs to be a shape in order to subtract something from it. So if I have this circle here, I want to cut it out of this photo, which is a photo. You see it here, I've imported it. If I put this on top here and select the photo too, so I've got two objects. If I use the subtract tool here, it's gonna do it, but it's gonna lose my photo size and everything. So that's not a good idea. So if I undo this, let me show you how to do it. So this is my photo here. I want to cut this shape out of it. The way to do it is really just select the photo and make a copy of it. Control J to duplicate. This is because you want to keep the shape, the size, and the shape of your photo. So I'm going to actually convert that to a curve now. So the duplicated copy, convert it to a curve. Click here, convert to curves like that. And then this is basically a shape. It still shows that fill, but actually, I want to take the second photo, the one I have not converted, and mask it inside of this shape, right? So select the photo, pull it up and to the right. And that's going to mask the photo inside of the other shape, which happens to not, it doesn't need to have that fill anymore. So it has no fill right now. So now this is a shape with a photo masked inside of it. So you take your other shape and let's say I want to cut out the sun from there. So I'm going to just place that here. I can resize it, do whatever I want. And now select this one and the photo shape that I selected, control to select both of them. And now you can use the subtract operation on them. So you can see now I punched a hole in here where the other shape was, and I can move it around, and you can see it is actually see-through there. And also, if you want, you can still click on the photo that's inside and move it around, resize it, so you retain that freedom of moving your photo inside of the other shape. So basically, you're creating a mask for the photo inside of a shape, and then you're cutting another shape out of it. This can be achieved the same way just by creating the shapes in advance. So if I do a new document here, just to illustrate that, I'm just going to do a new document here. So I'm going to go and select a rectangle like this and a circle like that. Just draw a circle on top of it. And you can see them now here. They're two shapes. Maybe if I want to change the color on this one, just so it's distinct, you see them. Select both of them using the shift key or whatever and use the subtract like so. So now you have a shape with a circle inside of it. So if I bring the photo in again and resize the photo to any size I need. All right, so now this is the same procedure. You have the photo, you have the shape. All you need to do is now put the shape of the photo inside of your shape, just in the layer panel, just drag it on top of the curves and to the right. So you notice when you drag it to the right, it just goes inside of that mask. And then you can open this whole object here and keep resizing your photo and do whatever you want. It's going to now have that shape cut out of it now. So this is, you can do it like that. But obviously, if you do it like this, you don't know exactly where your cutout is going to be. So that's why you start with the photo, make a copy, make it a shape, cut it out, and then it's going to be actually cut in place. So I hope this was helpful.